Hello, fifth graders. This is Mr. Scrow, and let's get started on today's lesson. Today, we are going to invite Miss Smith from Eisenhower School back to designing and leading our lessons for today. We are going to the great country of Australia. Let's get started.
By the end of this lesson, you will learn important facts about Australian history, geography, and culture. You will be able to identify important aspects of Aboriginal culture and music, and you will listen to popular Australian folk music and learn new Australian words. Here are some fast facts about Australia. The official name of Australia is the Commonwealth of Australia. As a Commonwealth of the United Kingdom, the head of state is the British monarch, in this case, Queen Elizabeth II from England. There is a debate in Australia that they should cut ties with the British monarchy and become their own republic. While that debate has not been settled, they are still a Commonwealth of England at this time. Australia is also the sixth largest country in the world. The capital of Australia is Canberra, but Sydney is the largest city in Australia. Australia is also the fourth largest producer of gold. Let's watch the video to learn more fun facts about Australia. Be ready to share something you've learned at the end.
This is Earth. Maybe you've heard of it? I sure hope so, because you live on one of its seven continents. This one's most known for its desert landscapes and unique animals. Australia. Australia is the smallest of the seven continents, and it's entirely surrounded by water. It's also the only country in the world that covers an entire continent. At almost 3 million square miles, Australia is located below Asia in the southern hemisphere. That's how it got its nickname, the Land Down Under. Life down under is very unusual. It can go from scorching dry temperatures to very subtropical. In the southern hemisphere, stars and constellations appear upside down and reversed compared to the northern hemisphere. This is because the Earth turns on its axis from the north to the south pole. Even the seasons are in reverse. So get out your winter parkas in the summer and surfboards during the holidays. And you'll definitely need sunscreen if you visit one of Australia's many deserts, like the Great Victoria Desert, the largest desert in the continent. Australia's warm, sunny climate and giant open spaces make for great outdoor adventures. Ready to camp out underneath the stars in the Australian outback? On clear nights, you can see almost 3,000 stars. Want to take a dip in the ocean? There are over 1,500 species of fish that live in the Great Barrier Reef, located in the Pacific Ocean, the largest coral reef in the world. Another natural wonder can be found in the heart of the continent, Uluru, a sacred rock formation that stands 1,100 feet tall. And, of course, there are some incredible animals in Australia, like kangaroos and emus that live on the coast, and the cute marsupials like koalas and wombats, and unique animals like the platypus and camels. Australia has almost 1,000 different reptile species, including some of the most dangerous snakes. Even though many of the world's deadliest species live here, Australia is home to over 24 million people. The continent's first people arrived in Australia about 50,000 years ago. Australia is one of the most ethnically and geographically diverse nations in the world. What an incredible place. A beautiful island. I mean, country. Wait, continent. Well, you know what I mean. All of the above. Australia.
Australia is one of the seven continents and located in the southern hemisphere. In fact, because of their location on the Earth, the seasons are a little different than here in the U.S. In Australia, it is warm in the winter and cold in the summer. Australia is made up of six states: Western Australia, South Australia, Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria, and Tasmania. Australia is also made up of territories. Those pictured on the map are the Northern Territory and the Australian Capital Territory. As mentioned in the video we watched, it is the only country to cover an entire continent. More than one-third of the country is made up of dry desert. In fact, the famous Australian Outback region contains the largest deserts in the country. Not many people live there due to the scorching temperatures, little water, and little to no vegetation. Most of the 25 million people that live in Australia can be found in the cities and farms located on the eastern coastline of the country. The temperatures are more tolerable there. How did Australia come to be, and who discovered the land down under? Dutch explorers arrived in what is now known as Australia in 1606. However, they weren't the first people to inhabit the land. More on that on the next slide. The British began to settle in Australia in 1788. Many of the British settlers were actually prisoners who were sent to Australia as a punishment. Gold was discovered in 1851, and this gold rush brought many new immigrants to the land in search for wealth. By 1859, six separate British colonies existed. Indigenous music is comprised of the music from the Aboriginal people of Australia. Aboriginal people have inhabited Australia for over 50,000 years. When the English settlers came to Australia, they got along with the Aboriginal people for a while, and then fighting broke out. Indigenous music is primarily instrumental music. On the following slides, we will look at three different Aboriginal instruments. The first instrument we will look at that is a traditional Aboriginal instrument is the didgeridoo. The didgeridoo is one of the oldest instruments in the world. It is made from eucalyptus trees and is a long tube with no finger holes or keys. It is considered the national instrument of Australian Aboriginal peoples. Take a look at the video to learn more about the didgeridoo.
Hi, my name is Sanshi from Didgeridoo Dojo. So, before we start our lessons, let's check it out. What is didgeridoo? Didgeridoo is an old instrument from Northern Australia played by Australian Aboriginal people. Using for ceremonies, and many, many songs are there and the dancing as well. Okay, so the didgeridoo is categorized in wooden, brass instrument. Brass instrument is made out of wood. Yes, it's wooden brass instrument. Brass instrument means the sound created by your vibration on your lips. So, going like that. Anyway, the like a trumpet, trombone, a horn even from Switzerland is categorized in brass instrument. So didgeridoo is made out by eucalyptus tree and eucalyptus tree hollowed out by termites. Check this out. It's a little grooves and the little holes. The little termites comes from the underground eating all the way up to the top of the tree. And tree finally fall down. But before, when the termites is perfect size for the didgeridoo, it's be harvested and then made out into the instruments. Typically just using the draw blade to shape the outside and small to long chisels to chiseling out inside. And you can tune the didgeridoo by the length. So this didgeridoo is key in E, about medium pitch. Your didgeridoo might be in different keys, for example, like these ones. Some are shorter, some are longer. Maybe shortest as in maybe 1 meter length, and the longer one can be over 2 meters long. Let's check this one now. Shorter ones. and the long ones. Usually short of the higher pitch and longer the more lower, deeper sounding. So didgeridoo comes in different sizes, different sounds, just like us having got a different voice. So it's really unique, right? Okay. Now, didgeridoo is played in the mouthpiece side and the sounds come from the other end. There you go. And then you can change your mouth shape and change the sound. So in our lesson, just step by step, we go through one by one technique. And I'm sure by end of the lesson, you're making an awesome sound. So let's start.
Another traditional Aboriginal instrument are the clapsticks. Unlike drumsticks, which typically strike a drum, clapsticks are used to strike one another. They are like rhythm sticks, which you may have used in music class in your elementary school. Clapsticks are used in traditional Aboriginal ceremonies and are often painted with Aboriginal art.
Clapsticks.
The final traditional Aboriginal instrument we will take a look at is the bull roarer. A bull roarer is a flat piece of wood with a few feet of cord attached to it. It was used for communication and in traditional rituals of the Aboriginal people. To play the bull roarer, one would have to twirl the cord and then wave the bull roarer above their head, almost like a cowboy using a lasso. Let's take a look at the video to listen to it.
Okay. What's your name?
Waranga Dungia. From down under.
Australian folk music is an important part of Australian culture. One of the most famous kinds of folk music is a bush ballad. A bush ballad is a type of folk music that depicts life in the Australian bush. The Australian bush is just another term to describe Australian farmland. The best-known bush ballad is Waltzing Matilda and is considered the unofficial national anthem of Australia. In this slide, we will listen to a little bit of Waltzing Matilda. As you listen, see if you can understand what's happening in the story. What words don't make sense to you? Could you figure out what they mean? Have a listen and let's discuss.
Once a jolly swagman campfire built a bomb under the shade of a coolabah tree, and he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You'll come a-waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Now that we've listened to the song, let's learn what some of those unfamiliar terms mean. A swagman is a man who traveled across Australia looking for work. Swagmen often traveled with all of their belongings. A billabong is another word for a body of water, and in this case, a lake. A kooluba tree is another name for a eucalyptus tree. A billy is not a name, but rather a can for boiling water. And the term waltzing Matilda means to travel with your belongings in a backpack or cloth. Let's listen to the song again, now that we have a better understanding of the story. While we listen, tap the steady beat.
Once a jolly swagman campfire built a bomb under the shade of a kooluba tree, and he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Here's another example of a famous folk pop song in Australia. It's called Tie Me Kangaroo Down Sport. It's a silly song about a man who thinks he's dying, and he's asking his friends to take care of his things if he does. What type of things is the man asking his friends to do? Be ready to share what you hear after we listen.
There's an old Australian stockman lying dying. And he gets himself up onto one elbow and he turns to his mates who are gathered around and he says, "Watch me wallabies feed, mate. Watch me wallabies feed. They're a dangerous breed, mate. So watch me wallabies feed all together now.
Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
Keep me cockatoo cool, curl. Keep me cockatoo cool. Oh, don't go acting the fool, curl. Just keep me cockatoo cool. All together now.
Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
And take me koala back, Jack. Take me koala back. He lives somewhere out on the track, Mac. So take me koala back all together now.
Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
Let me abos go loose, Lou. Let me abos go loose. They're of no further use, Lou. So let me abos go loose all together now.
Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
And mind me platypus duck, Bill. Mind me platypus duck. Oh, don't let him go running amok, Bill. Just mind me platypus duck all together now.
Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
Play your didgeridoo, Blue. Play your didgeridoo. Keep playing till I shoot through, Blue. Play your didgeridoo. All together now.
Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
Tan me hide when I'm dead, Fred. Tan me hide when I'm dead.
So we tanned his hide when he died, Clyde. And that's it hanging on the shed all together now.
Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
There are a ton of musicians that have influenced American music and culture that are actually Australian. Did you know that these bands and singers were from Australia? The rock group AC/DC is an Australian group. The pop group 5 Seconds of Summer comes from Australia. Country music star Keith Urban is Australian. And yep, that childhood group that sings about fruit salads, the Wiggles, they are also from Australia. Your assignment for this week is to complete the exit ticket in your Google Classroom. We'll see you next time in the land down under for week 2 of Australian music.